1500 or nothing. Yeah, yeah, yo, yo, this one's for the people. All the bees that'll bleed and sleep and the east should breathe. I thought we all equal. Ain't a man on the God's green bee underneath any other. I don't wanna play preacher, but I swear they turn a ear when we talk about peace and love. Sometimes might need a hug. Yeah, we all wanna come on up above, but this ain't about Jesus. No way, no aim, no like Moses. So I have a guess.
Food deserts themselves are really quite common, and when an individual is more than a mile or two away from a place where they can acquire fresh fruits and vegetables and have a decent selection of, or a choice, the government considers them to be disadvantaged, and in fact they are. Many of the communities don't have public transport, and if there's not public transport that gets you to a food source, you're stuck with what you have and what's in walking distance. And this leads to a poor choice, a poor selection of what can be purchased, leaving the mother and or the father to choose from things that are less healthy for their children than they would like.
All right, we're standing on the eastern edge of City Seeds Urban Farm. It's a 2.5 acre farm in downtown St. Louis, on which last year we grew about 10,000 pounds of produce, and this year we're aiming for 15,000. We run two programs out here, a job training program and a therapeutic program. The gentlemen who are out here today are part of the job training program. Most recently, we received a specialty crop grant from the Missouri Department of Agriculture, which has allowed us to pay stipends to our clients who are out here.
I think it's like two phases, but anyway, when I finish this, you know, hopefully, you know, I'll be qualified to get a job. My understanding that the job placement is pretty high here.
They have support from a job developer at St. Patrick's Center. Once they complete the program, we have relationships with local landscaping companies as well as recycling companies, and we have about a 75% job placement rate of graduates from the job training program.
It gives me something to do, and I feel great about being able to contribute something, you know, to the cause.
About 60% of our produce goes to food outreach, which provides nutritional support for individuals living in St. Louis with HIV, AIDS, and cancer. Another 35% goes to Tower Grove Farmers Market, where therapeutic clients work to sell the produce and socialize with other individuals in the city.
The stuff that isn't as beautiful, but it's still very edible, we get to take home and cook. So last week I took some beets and radishes, and today I'm going to take some greens home and learn how to cook those.